So, I haven't beat this game or played it since I was a teenager. So it's probably been like 13 years, maybe. But I've never really played this version, so I thought it'd be cool. I did figure out how to get it to run, though. That took me a second. I wasn't used to the load times. I thought it was broken, but no, it just loads forever. Like, this is a load screen, I think. Yeah, and then I ask you to shift sides of the disk. Do with shift B. And then it loads again, and then you're in the game. Oops, sorry. Punched my mic. There we go. That's a slightly different jingle. I think the sound effects, this version has more sound effects. More instrument tracks, I think, for the songs. Another difference is, oh, I thought this version didn't have this. You can hold B to auto fire, but I guess it has it. Maybe it's not as fast. I think the first thing we do is get missiles and then morph ball bomb. These guys are gonna get in my way. Oh yeah, I'm gonna have arthritis by the end of this. So, this is the first tunnel, vertical tunnel. Needs to get a little monotonous. That's why you want to get high jump. So this leads to a second vertical tunnel. And missiles are easy to get at the bottom of it. Hell yeah. Is this the bottom of it? Yeah. There should be missiles right here. Yeah. So I think one of the huge differences in this version is when you die, you restart at the beginning of the planet, not the zone that you're in. Which can be ridiculous. But I think I can use that to my benefit. Alright, so we want to go back up because the morph ball bombs are up here. You just need missiles to get in the door. Missiles in this game, it costs 5 of them to open missile doors. So you have to keep that in mind. What's going on, Cricky? Let me know if the game volume's too low. The ice beam, you can get it under the next room, I think. Okay. Yeah, ice beam should be down there. Here's our first E tank. Hey. Hey. I didn't even take damage. Alright, so more fall bombs are up here. I think what I want to do is go get the high jump and screw attack before doing too much else. It's Gamer. So annoying. Okay. Let's not shoot these guys on accident. Okay. Okay, we got more ball bombs. I don't think there's anything secret in there. Yeah! I think these guys make a different sound in this version, I'm not sure. What are these guys called? Skeevers? Okay, so we can grab the ice beam. We'll just have to get some missiles. Where's it at? Ah, it's here. Hey, okay. I think I'm just gonna death warp after this because I don't remember how to get out of this room. Oh, yeah, so not annoying. Let's get some more missiles. I think we'll get some more. These fucking guys. Almost enough. I don't have enough. Hey, there we go. How do you get out of this room? Is it this way? Think you actually need high jump, so I think I might just death warp. Have a lot of health to be death warping. Yeah, I'm dying on purpose. I just want to get back to the beginning of Brinstar. I think continue's the option. I haven't played this version. We'll see if I still have an ice beam or not. I do. Okay. Now we have Morphball Bomb, so we could go down to do Kraid. But I'm not going to. Okay, so at the top left, not the top left, but like up to the left, I believe is the beam extender behind a missile door. Now, I don't know if I will actually want the beam extender because it makes shooting at things a little tricky. Because your bullets, you can only have a certain amount on the screen at a time. And because they decay so fast with a short beam, it's easy to spam them. So if you miss a shot, with the extended beam, I think it makes the game a little harder. I'm gonna grab it anyway. Could be here. After this, I want to say we go down to Norfair and grab the high jump slash quick or slash you know whatever it's called, the fucking spinny attack jump screwball. Okay, so we drop back down to here. We slam our hand into our desk because that's optimal. Probably need some health. You can farm on these guys, but they're kind of annoying because as soon as you pick that up, they respawn. So if you pick it up over the tube, you'd be aware that they're right underneath you. But you can freeze them and bypass them that way. Alright, so this leads to Norfair and our first ridiculous load time. Because the disk system version of this game has loading screens. And this is what it looks like. Yeah, because that wouldn't convince you your game's broken. Probably could have. We could have lit that smoke during the load screen, but whatever. Alright, so we go right? Because this should lead right then down to, I want to freeze that guy and get him out of here. The high jump? So a lot of enemy patterns in this version of the game are randomized. It uses a different type of random number generator. And with that, it doesn't decide what direction an enemy is going to attack in when you enter the room. Instead, in this version, the enemies will attack in either direction all the time. So that's actually kind of cool, in my opinion. I believe we drop down here. Somewhere. Hey. And the next door on the left. The jumpy boot. Yeah, those guys, I think they decide wherever they want to fucking shoot. He just hit me in the door transition. Okay. Let me move my mic. Alright, this room's actually annoying as fuck. Oh, perfect. Let's get on there. Okay. Okay. Yeah, I remember this. Hey. Don't shoot me! Sit here for a second. Gotta get some health back. touch it. Okay, whatever. Oh, fuck. So, in this green room, I believe, is the screw attack. Up here. From here, you go grab an energy tank, I think. Wouldn't be a bad idea. Ow. I was thinking just early game Varia suit. Where's it at? There we go. I'm gonna die in this room. Oh my god. I didn't expect that to kill him. What a fucking good ass item. These fucking rocks. Yeah. Dude, screwball. So good. Do I need that? I don't think I do. I don't actually remember this. Is it the lava that's fake? Aha. I think I'm stuck. Fucking A. Hey, that wasn't a screw attack. Alright. So... How do you go back through here? I could just death warp. Go back, get the various suit, grab another E tank, and then kill Kraid, I think. Probably a decent idea. Oh, what? Really? I thought it started you back in fucking Brinstar. That's crazy. I thought I read that somewhere. Maybe it's the other game. Maybe I got it backwards. Alright. Just no health. Alright, cool. I need a shitload of missiles to even fight the bosses. I think each boss area gives you a lot of missiles. Ah! I don't remember shit about this part. Didn't mean to blow that up again. Are they really gonna put that in? Alright. Hey, I'm a different color. What's the way through here? Isn't there a way through here? Oh, yeah, okay. Okay. Let me just go back and drop down and go back and drop down. This is more ballroom. Alright, this will lead back to the ice beam chamber. What should we do first, Crate or Ridley? I think Crate, right? What the? Nah, we should do it. Crate is this way? Yeah. Or wait, isn't there a fucking E-tank over here? Yeah. How do you get it? I think you have to ice beam somebody. But who? Can I get him over here? He'll ever want to come over here? I had him. Well, I did have him. Come over here, you jackass. Oh my god, I know you see me. No! Well, that was unfortunate. Try that again. Please. Gotta be the most annoying dude. Don't do that. Okay. That got complicated with the screw attack. Loading. Oh yeah. Good old Creed theme. Freaking mega hoppers. What happened? He's hopping everywhere. Okay, got some missiles. Okay. They're like, no, don't come in here. Bruh. This mega hopper. Y'all gonna let me out of here? Oh, that doesn't even work. That didn't work. That didn't work at all. How do you get out of this? Sure, this is totally the intended way to do this. I think. I almost blasted myself over it. Damn, look how much health we have already. Wait, how do you get out of here? How do you get out of here? Interesting. God, they did kill him. So, Kraid's lair. You can get some missiles this way. If you're not a dunce. I can't believe the metal hoppers only give you 5 HP, but then the upgraded, what are they, skeevers or whatever, they'll give you like 15. Oh, 1 second. My mom made a pie, and she wants me to try it. So I'm gonna try the pie. Yeah, this is a good-ass pie. Sweet potato. The crust is really flaky and good. Mmm. Good pie. Alright, where was I? Right, we're in Kraid's lair. I just fell on accident. So, I'll just go back. And there's a metal hopper right in the fucking door! God, what an asshole. They're actually living up... You know how annoying metal hoppers were in the text-based version of this game? Like, there are so many elements that they got right. Just the right amount of annoying. I think this is this leads to missiles, it also leads to Kraid's lair. I can't remember how many missiles you'd want when fighting Kraid. And I do know in this version his attacks are more randomized. Which is neat. Alright, we're in a tunnel right now, and I think that means the bottom left. Yeah, this is a missile. God, annoying enemies. Now, this tunnel itself leads to Kraid, I believe. You think they put all this here for you to regen? No, they put it here to annoy you. I guess I could just do this from a safer distance. See, isn't this exactly like what I was doing in the text maze version? Can you injure Kraid with the ice beam? See, in Dread, they replaced all of these tubes with automatic regen statues. Same concept. Except in the original, these tubes have varying degrees of difficulty. This one's pretty nice, though. And the statues are instant. I probably don't need all this HP. I've got hella HP. But I don't want to die. I really don't know if I have enough missiles. And there is a missile pack in Kraid's lair that I think I failed to pick up. It's kind of a long walk. Alright, fuck it, let's go! Oh, these guys are in here too. I fucking love the design of this room. It's so tight. Get my missiles back. Oh, you have to hit him in the back. Right? I don't actually remember. Oh, he's just screaming. Kind of makes you feel bad. Die, you son of a bitch! Can I screwball this guy? You can. Right onto his head. I'm gonna die.
Oh!
Holy shit, I had 50 HP left. Fuck. Isn't there an E-tank somewhere around here? Yeah, it's right here. How do I get it? How do you get it? Let me in. How do you actually get that? I need more health to try to get it. You want to look up how to collect that? I guess I'll look it up. I honestly don't remember. Unless it's one of these guys. Can you, like, get one of these guys to come over and then ice off of them? Roll from the door? Okay, so break it and then roll from the door. Well, if I can even get the fuck out of here. Haha! That's so stupid. Okay, thanks. Alright, so now I just gotta get the fuck out of here. Yes, this game is like, yes, I want you to climb this shit. Fucking hell. How fucking long is this part? Oh my god. Okay. Yeah, that wasn't risky or anything. Yeah, Get me the fuck out of here. We just go back up out the top, I think. Well, we had to wrap around to there. Well, I probably could have iced. Actually, let's grab the missile container. Fuck it. Where am I right now? Where's the missile container? It's in, the missile container is, like, on a fucking left thing, right? Oh, it's all the way at the top, though. I'm actually in the middle right now. That's why I was confused. I like the little robot dudes. Yeah. Every boss zone has a ridiculous amount of missiles you can acquire. Because they're useful for not getting destroyed by the boss. This is the way to the missile pickup. Actually, wait. Didn't I already... Oh, wait. There's one at the bottom. That's what it is, right? I grabbed the one at the top. I should put select on a different button, so I could... I hate the fucking size of the share button on a PS4. Oh, thanks. You get damaged so much in between rooms. Ah! Alright, let's go. What's the way back up? I think the way back's up, back up is just this way. It's getting eaten alive here. Oh, fuck. 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 There we go. This room is fucking deadly. Okay. Yep, everybody just get a hit on me as I'm leaving. I'm actually gonna do that real quick. I'm changing my select button. Like R1 so that it mimics the inputs for the newer games. There we go. I'm at the bottom, right? And I go left, and then I go back up. Have either of you guys beat this game? Are you part of the Zero Mission is a good game squad? Hell no, it's not that bad. Well, that doesn't work. Looks like absolute dog shit. Okay. this was like legit my intro to the series, and I beat it before playing any other game. Because I'm not a coward. I have good taste. No, I played it for the first time like fucking 15 years after it came out. Well, not the first time, but like a legit attempt. Alright, so I'm just leaving, right? For these sick Famicom load screens. Oh, I should eat more of this pie. Goddamn, it's good. I think it's cool how many things in these old games, like, originated in the older games that you see in, like, newer games. My favorite example is, like, Zelda 2. Not a lot of people played Zelda 2, but all of the cities in there give their names to, like, all the characters in the 64 games. Like, Kakariko Village is in Zelda 2. How the fuck do I get out of here? I like Zelda 2. It's actually a tight game. You can play Zelda 2, but you can't play this. Zelda 2 is way harder than this. You have to actually, like, game the fucking AI of of all the enemies and shit. It's like a fucking fighting game. Am I going the right way? You guys got me talking and shit. Yeah, I'm going the right way. This is the first tube. That means Norfair's over here. And I'm going down. Yeah. The beginning of Zelda 2 is probably, like, the most confusing thing. But once you get, you know, like, the candle and the hammer and everything, and understand what it wants you to do, it gets a lot simpler. But then still, I mean, even the it never explains that you can go through keyholes as a fairy. It is really cryptic about where the fucking skeleton key is at. I beat that game without the skeleton key. And the only reason I beat it was because my mom told me to try flying through the keyhole in the door as a fairy. And I was like, that's hilarious. That'll never work. And then I was able to beat the game. I just remember being stuck in the last dungeon for 2 days. And then I was like, Mom, what the fuck do I do? Because I just asked her out of, like, fucking desperation. And, she was like, well, you can turn into a fairy. Just fly through the keyhole. And I was like, yeah, right. And then it worked. I just don't know why her first guess was, the correct answer. Yeah. Sometimes you just need, like, an outside perspective on things. Oh, I eat this pie.
It's pretty early, dude.
Five? Not bad. Oh, get this. Alright, so my nephews are, I think my nephews are 10 and 3. Anyway, they were playing Ninja Turtles 3 Manhattan Project the other day and made it to the fucking sewer. Like, how the fuck are those kids gonna make it past the bridge with Bebop, the fucking crumbling city afterward, kill Dirtbag, and then make it to the sewer? I'm just like, what the fuck are you on? What room am I going to? Is this the right way? I can just go up, I think. Yeah. I don't know if you guys have played Manhattan Project, but well, it's really good and you should play it. But also, it's crazy for some children to get that far. On their first try, too. Like, I don't even think they'd played the game yet. We were just like, yo, play this. Can I go up this way? I don't think you can. Get your wrap around. Oh, don't fall. Hey. This is the other ice beam you can get. I already have ice beam. It's actually like an exact replica of the other. Oh, so that you can switch back and forth between the beams because Metroids are weak to ice, and if you go into the final section with a wave beam, I think that's a bad idea. So you have the option to switch, I think. I believe that's what's intended. Is this the room that leads to the... I think so. Right? No, wait, am I doing this wrong? Yeah. I think the beam's over right. They don't combine in this game. I think I'm just gonna pass up the wave, the wave beam, the penetrating beam. Thank you. I gotta think about where I'm at. This is, wait, that room leads to the ice beam, okay. This room is back where I came from. The next one down led to, well, you bomb down to the high jump. I wanna say there's missiles in this room? Fucking die! Just fucking annoying. Oops. Let me just miss every single jump. Wait, didn't I already come this way? I probably have these missiles already. No, all right, it's just the similar looking room. You know, I probably should have went and got that other missile pack first. These guys are fucking annoying. Oh my god, leave me alone! Jesus. Yeah, those enemies, they have like a randomized spray in this version, I think. Jerks. This is fun. I miss playing this game. Good thing I went and grabbed the various suit. Jesus, I'm just eating damage on all these enemies. So I'm back in the middle room, you could drop down like all the way, I think. Wait a second, let me think. Yeah. Is the intro, or the intro, the entrance to Ridley is at the bottom of like the long shaft on the right. There's a couple of missiles I don't feel like going back to grab that are kind of like around the wave beam that I'm probably just not gonna get. I could just go get it. Oh, yeah, whatever. Okay, I'll just come back for the ice beam. Where was the hole? Okay, so the high jump route goes to a wraparound, I think. I wonder if it matters if I went and got the other ice beam already. That would suck. That would be really bogus, actually. Maybe I should think about this. I wonder if it becomes collectible again. Hey, that's a bad jump. Oh, I think I just did a wall jump. What the fuck was that? Did I grab the E-tank over here? Did I? I think I did. Get out. All right, that's all that's down here. I mistimed it. Perfect. Oh, what the fuck? What is this, some kind of death trap? Wait, how do you actually get out of here? Is this a death trap? Wait a second. That sucks. Yeah, I got it. Okay, he's at the top. He's just at the top of the fucking lava for your jump. I was being dumb. I'm pretty sure that's the only thing at the end of this path. Pretty hard path just for a missile to go. Do I want this? Yeah, why not? I'll use it for Ridley. So what's the way out of here? I gotta go all the way back to the long shaft. With this much health, I could probably just death warp it and get away with it. But. Up with this laser. Are you gonna fucking work? Oh, whatever. To the energy pack. I don't think you can kill those. Right, this is the top half. Thank you. I don't remember. Is this it? Or no, I'm already below, but this is the entrance. I'm derping. Oh my god, it's slow. Good old NES load screens. Alright, so just give me 1 second. I'm gonna take my dishes back upstairs. Enjoy the. Alright. If I can. I'm not sure. Okay, missiles are. I thought you might have to freeze them first. Ooh. That was not the right... You have to bomb jump this? Or... wait, you can't go this way. I think that's what it was. I think you can't go that way. Whatever, these guys give you a lot of health. I'll take it. This is like the health regen room. Alright, this is the middle room with the elevator. This is the right tunnel. I think this leads to... I could grab... let's just grab the missiles, I think. Fine. I don't remember where Ridley's at. If I walk into Ridley, this is Ridley. I get more health. Now if they could just drop some missiles, that would be... Whatever. I guess I'll go into 36 minutes. What's the strat for this guy? Can't you just, like, sit in the lava underneath him or something? Like, he's right here. Okay.
10 missile door? I couldn't remember. So all there's left to do is to get, an energy tank, fight Mother Brain, I think. Back to the tunnel. Okay, so I want to go back to the top of the tunnel. Or no, I want to go to the fucking middle. Oh yeah, the top. You know, I think it just hit me. I don't know how to get that fucking air. So I might just skip it. I honestly can't remember. I guess I'll just leave without it. I honestly don't remember how to get it. Okay. Go fight Mother Brain. Oh, actually, let's get the Ice Beam. Ice Beam. Myself a glass of water. Ice Beam's back at the top of this rightmost shaft. I'm trying to think. I think you just go back up it. That was an accident? Oh, I'm just killing it right now. Yes, thank you. Back through here. I think the first time I played this game, I did this whole portion without the Various suit, and I didn't know about that Ridley trick at all. I found out about that Ridley trick when I was looking up the game afterward. Kali, I got the various suit until I went to fight Mother Brain. This isn't the right way. All the way up at the top. Not there, is it? Oh yeah, it is. Yeah. Oh wait, don't you need the ice beam to get the ice beam? I'm not in the right room. I just realized that. I was like, this thing is still going. How do you do this without the ice beam? Can you go in from the back? Then you drop down and come into the back of it. The discoloration of it. I hope this is still here. Thank God. Okay. Okay. Can I leave this direction? Hey, whoa, everybody calm down, okay? Yo, chill out. Those guys shoot a random amount of fireballs in this version. I think in the NES version they shoot either one or three, and in this version they shoot one, two, three. Alright, so we have the ice beam. This leads back to the elevator shaft, so we'll do that. Kinda feels bad only missing like one item in the whole game, but I don't care. I don't remember how to get it. Alright, now for one of those sick load screens. That, I probably missed something else. Maybe. I don't know, maybe not. And we're there. I love fucking every time in every Metro game you come back to fucking the starting area with all your power ups. Best feeling. Get hit. It doesn't matter. Alright, so we're back in yellow vertical tunnel. We want to go left to the blue tunnel and then up to. That's the extendo beam room. Oh. Yeah. This is Turian. Well, this is the locked door anyway. Probably pick up a little bit of stuff here. I need missiles, dude. Give me some fucking missiles. Oh my god. Oh, fucking ice beam. Alright, whatever. Screw you guys. Going home. We did it. And this is where Mother Brain resides. Korean. I believe is what it's called. Super sick load screen. And there. Fuck, Metroids! Who forgot about Metroids existing? Me. I totally fucking forgot. Jesus. You ever play Metroid and forget that Metroids exist? After you go back and get an ice beam to prepare for them? Thank you. Mother Brain's just at the bottom of this shaft. God, these things are... Don't they drop anything? Come on. Oh, that was cool. Room. Isn't there a similar trick for Mother Brain herself where you kind of tip below her? God, these things are fucking annoying. Oh my god, they regenerate? Holy shit! The missile. Do I not have enough missiles to beat this? God. You need more, don't you? These things don't drop them. So what do I do exactly? Do I just back out? It'd be cool if I remembered anything about this fight. Die? Fuck. My first, like, actual death on Mother Brain. God damn it. Oh yeah, good stuff. Well, I guess I go farm some fucking missiles. Oh god. In the future, remember, Metroids don't drop missiles in this game as much as you'd like them to, so you can mostly just avoid them, I think, and then save all of your missiles for the last boss, because that's the only way to damage it. You remember so much, yet so little. Whatever. Only like a couple. A little bit of backtracking. Whatever. There's a good. Oh my god, good job. Freaky. Is hers? Come out of your homes. Huh. Oh my god. Come on. Come on. This isn't very fast if they don't fucking spawn anything. Yeah, feeling when you're at the end of a game and you were like, yeah, I'm gonna be done in like 2 hours. That was fast. Then you forget how difficult Mother Brain is and how you can only damage her with missiles. I think in this version, I feel like in the old version you could get missile pickups from, you know, it was just from her donuts. Bro, you guys just don't drop shit now. These guys are just done. They're like, no, you have enough health. Walk out and back. You see what he said? I don't want to lose health. Okay. how long I think it'll take to max out my shit. And he messaged me. Well, if I don't miss that jump, I can do it quite fast. I could just look up how many missiles it takes to kill her, and stop early. Wait a minute. I want to say it's at 50. This takes so long. Is it the ice beam that increases the drop rate, maybe? Oh, I totally unfroze him on accident. I think that's what it was in the text-based game. Whatever, I guess we're almost there. Fucking up. to reset the room real quick. I assume. I don't know how this works. Oh, okay. Cool. Let's restart the room again. And after this, I think I should be good. I don't want to go down there with not enough missing. I could have just regened off these guys. They always drop 20. I want to bet when I go back down there, all of her doors regen. So each one of those was 10, I think. So you need 40 to get to the boss, I think. Remember how many doors there were. That's if I don't miss. The boss is probably quite a few. You guys want to drop missiles at all for me? Appreciate it. This is gonna suck. Let me see what else it said. Oh. I'm not a dog. Don't you love monotonous farming in video games? This added a, like 30 minutes onto my run. Oh, I have enough. I really don't know. Because I can't. Someone Google how many missiles it takes to kill Mother Brain. Probably about. What's my max missiles even at? Might have collected all of them. Which should have made this easier, but of course I just didn't top off before I went in. Idiot. And then I played it incorrectly. This is so whack. Oh man, I forgot what happens when you die to Mother Brain. Oh, I forgot. You know I'm fucking save stating. Once I get fucking damn missiles. Fucking die! This has got to be enough. There's no way it's not. Alright, whatever. Let's go. There, whatever. We save stated. I'm not fucking farming anymore.
Oh, shit.
Okay, yeah, you just don't fight the Metroids. You don't fight them at all. You just freeze them, and you move. Because I'm so used to playing newer Metroid games where they want you to kill them, and they give you rewards for doing that. But my last attempt... They cry when you step on them. Nine health. Away from me. All right, let me buy. Okay. Doors are still down, I think. Tight. Okay, let's do this. Damage. Oh, does our health remain the same too? Probably not. Let's not fucking fall in here and die because of it. Oh, thank God. Come the fuck on. God, these things hurt. Oh, seizure alert. Holy shit. I did it. Was Metroid on the Famicom? Switch to the other side of the disc. I guess stores the credits and the save. Great, you fulfilled your mission. It will revive peace in the space, but it may be invaded by the other Metroid. Pray for a true peace in the space. It's a girl. Metroid was a girl the whole time. I guess there's a lot of grammatical errors in the credits that they changed in the NES version. Things like directed instead of director. Oh, you know what I think it was? I think you can use passwords to restart your game in Norfair. But if you load your game in the Famicom version, you always start in Brinstar, I think. Okay. Let's see how many money bags I got. Oh, I only got four. You can get five money bags.
for how fast you beat the game, but I really fucking took a lot of time at the end there. Yeah. You don't really get anything cool. Like, you don't get to play as Samus with her suit on. That was for the NES version. You just get money bags, I think. But I believe you do still restart the game with all your stuff. We'll see if that's the case. Oh, well, we almost got 5 money bags, but that was a bad mother brain fight. Loading into the game. Nope, it just restarts with nothing. Alright, well, that was Metroid on the Famicom. Thanks for watching. Appreciate you guys. Till next time.